and the ballad Victorian for the Glee double act.
Yeah, it was a hard pick. There was a lot of us. I graduated in the top 10% of my class. Hello.
Hi. Hi.
I would first like to thank all the faculty, family, and friends who have helped me get here. Thanks to you all. I would also like to take a second to thank my beautiful children, McKenna, Morel, and little Eloise. I apologize for not being as present as I normally would be these last 3 years. But there is no one I would like to thank more than my wonderful wife. I'm so excited for our future. It's going to be awesome. Person graduating today who will get paid to be a minister, I hope. However, there are 71 others here today who can go out and spread the Lord's love free of charge. That's you guys. Some of you guys may not know me very well, but I am no square. For those of you who have never heard that term, it means boring nerd. I started theological school when I was 41 years old, so I have lived a little. When I was out there in the working world being a circle, that's not a term, I just made it up. Anyway, when I was out your age, or most of your ages, out there in the world being a circle, rolling around from one thing to the next, and sometimes one job to the next, there was one thing that kept me rolling off the path completely. That thing was the Lord, the word of the Lord, which I consider to be the Old and New Testament and the heavenly doctrines. You have just graduated from a school that upholds that same declaration. It is the Lord's word alone that has helped me to be a better student, a better worker, a better person, a better father, and a better husband. Excuse me. Nothing gained or derived from the world alone will fill you with purpose and happiness, like the purpose and happiness you can get from understanding the word and wanting to do good for your neighbor and the Lord. Hopefully you all think this way now and will not have to learn the hard way through the unhappiness that arises from seeing yourself as the center of the universe. I would like to give all you graduates some of the best advice you will ever get. Not because it is the kind of advice that I might give, but because it is the kind of advice that the Lord might give. A lot of people don't remember that on top of the 12 disciples, Jesus sent out 70 other disciples into the world to spread his word in the book of Luke. 70 disciples. That's about the same number of graduates we have here today. We are going to cover 5 pieces of advice that Jesus gave to the 70 right before he sent them out. This is advice we all can take and listen to and make use of. He said, "The harvest truly is great, but the laborers are few. Therefore, pray the Lord of the harvest to send the laborers into his harvest." What this is saying to us through the internal sense could be put like this. There is a lot of good in the world. It's everywhere if you wish to see it. Go out there and make it more visible. See the greater possibilities everywhere. The second thing Jesus told them, go your way, behold, I send you out as lambs among wolves. This means do not be taken in by those that wish to destroy innocence. Some people out there try and make a lot of bad things seem really good. Don't let indifferent, unmotivated, or downright creepy people convince you that you or other people aren't worth the effort. You're always worth the effort. The third thing Jesus instructed them on, carry neither money bag, knapsack, nor sandals, and greet no one along the road. This doesn't mean get rid of your Louis Vuitton handbags or your Yeezy shoes. You can keep those. This means don't make your baggage your life. Don't be one of those people who goes to work and complains about everything, always. Don't make a personal problem you have the focus of your entire life. The Lord wants you to overcome your problems. If all you see is your problems, you will become apathetic to good things. You will think there's no good with yourself or with others. There is plenty of love and goodness that humanity hasn't even tapped into yet. If you are thankful of technology, like your cell phones, because of this great technological boom we're in right now, just imagine how much more thankful we would all be if we were to experience a boom in goodness and love from the Lord. The fourth thing Jesus said to them, but whatever house you enter, first say peace to this house. This means be good to people, even if they're stinkers. Wish good for people. Expect good from other people. Want the world to be a better place. It will make a difference. The fifth thing, and the last thing I will relate to you, that Jesus said to these 70. And if a son of peace is there, your peace will rest on it. If not, it will return to you. This means your love and your useful work in the world will change everything. And don't forget it. Stay diligent. The heavenly doctrines that we all have had exposure to make an invitation to humanity to go deeper into the things of faith. The truth from these books urge us to lead our life from good intentions, our ideals, our loves, and bring forth those good intentions through our actions. Let's go out into the world and show people how we shine from the inside out. Let's go make things more efficient and of higher quality. Whether we work at White Castle or the White House. Let's bring happiness to the workplace instead of apathy, whether we work at Gold's Gym or Goldman Sachs. Let's make the world a better place, not for ourselves, but for others. The quality of our lives will be determined by the quality of our use to others. There are 72 of us that graduated today that can spread the Lord's love. Remember, the Lord is love itself. He always loves you and wants you to be happy. Don't be a hater. Love him back through all of your actions. Thank you.